Hey folks, this is Alan from On the Course 59, and today we're going to talk about BCG's rubber weight set. These things are heavy, obviously, and let's get right to it. All right, we'll start with the bad stuff first because, you know, this is usually what everybody wants to know. Like, are these worth it? Are they bad? Is there something wrong with them? And if there's something negative about them, it's usually something that people want to know first anyways. So, where to start? The knurl. Let's start with the knurl. And the knurl on here is pretty aggressive. It's an aggressive knurl. It's pretty sharp. It's a pretty sharp knurl. Let's bring this up to the camera a little bit. Alright. This knurl, it's pretty sharp on the hands, it's pretty rough, and after using them for a couple months, like, I've seriously got some pretty hard calluses on there. It hasn't ripped off my skin yet. This is a 20-pound weight. I don't know if you see that on the camera, but it's 20-pound, and it doesn't slip. It doesn't slip at all. That knurl does exactly what it's supposed to do. But yeah, it's sharp. I mean, it kind of digs in a little bit, so it does dig in. Next, after handling the weights, especially if you're doing like grip exercises like this, they have this tendency to leave crap all over your hands. I don't know if y'all can see. Let's see if we can. Yeah. Alright. That came right off the way. It just a little rub. Just think about if you're sweaty and moving around a whole bunch, you know, doing crazy weird things. Who knows what you do with weights? Left with them. Oh! We'll get to that in a second. But they have a tendency to leave crap all over your hands if you're touching the rubber itself, which is, it's disgusting. I really don't like that. And that drives me nuts, actually. So, the size is the, I guess, would be, we're going in, no. Alright. That's the bad thing about these weights. I think they're also, a bit of a difference in size. This is 10. This is 10. This is your standard home Gold's Gym weight that you can pick up at Walmart. This is the BCG weight, rubber weight that you pick up at Academy. I think it's Academy. Anyway, so that's 10, much bigger difference in size. So if you're doing more grip exercises to develop your forearms, I mean, at 10 you're going to get a better grip on out of the Walmart version than the 10 for the BCG. So, I've got small hands, so the 10 weight works perfectly for me. The Walmart version. Okay, so those are probably my big three beefs right there. Oh, and last but not least, I really hate the smell of rubber. It drives me crazy. And these things stink. They really stunk when I brought them out of the box. I had to, like, let them air out for a couple hours before I'd get close to them. So yeah, these things pretty much stunk when I got them because of the rubber smell. Alright, so the accuracy of these weights is pretty good. I only have a home scale, this right down there, but I tested them out. The 25 actually weighed 25, and the 20 actually weighed like 19.6, and the 15 weighed like 14.8 or something like that. But my scale only goes down to so far before it couldn't read the 10 or the 5s. I mean, it's just not physically capable of doing that kind of stuff. So I didn't weigh those. I tried, but I couldn't get a reading. So, all right, droppability. I've dropped a couple of these things just to test it out. And all that's left is just a black scuff on my floor. This is a laminate wood flooring, so it's just pieced together cheap wood flooring. It's not real wood, I'm sure, but that'd be a definite thing. But I drop them all the time when I get fatigued or I slip or something like that. So, but they don't really dent my floor any. There's concrete under here, so that's also a nice thing. They don't really scuff up or chip out, but they're still fairly new, so that might be a big thing too. They're still fairly new, so there's that. Last but not least, they look kind of cool. I mean, they got the nice, clear, shiny, chrome-plated handle, got the big, black, you know, aggressive-looking thing. They look modernized. That's always a big bonus, is having your stuff look modernized. Like, hey, I'm going into a modern gym, this is what I've got. You know, these look really good, like industry standard setting stuff. The stand is pretty sturdy. I mean, it's not going to go anywhere. It's got a T-shaped legging that works really well. Here, I'll show you here in a moment. Alright. Obviously, it's got a nice little T-shape on the base of the stand. It doesn't really have a tipping point, and the lower rack has an angle on it, I guess for easier access to those weights in there. So that's really not that bad, I don't think. So I like the stand. I think it was a good design for the way it sets itself. Other than that, I think that's pretty much it. So we looked at the stand. You got my opinion on the weights. That's not bad. I guess cost. I think they're probably too much for what I paid for them, just because they're plastic coated weights. But I mainly bought it for the stand right here because obviously I lack a bunch of space for, I guess, big heavy super equipment stuff everywhere. So I have to make do with small things that I can keep compacted places. So, would I pay full price for this system? Probably not. I think if I added up the weight and everything, say suggested retail cost, that the maximum, the absolute maximum you could or should pay for this is about $170. Now, that's a maximum, okay? I would definitely pay $140 or $130 for this in a heartbeat. So that's definitely what I would do. I think you'd get a much better deal off a modular or a more adaptive system, like dumbbells with standard weights or something like that. So you could get more out of the weights that you do buy. I like this system for what it is, but I don't think paying full price for it would benefit anybody. Hey folks, thanks for checking out my YouTube channel. Don't forget to subscribe, because you never know what I'm going to post next. That's for sure, because I do karate, course running. I've got more stuff to review, as always, because what good is all this stuff if I don't check it out and share my own personal experiences with you, who's not a professional athlete, but a large enthusiast. I'm working on a Facebook page as I'm making this for On the Course 59.
I've also got a nice little Instagram going. It's on course59, where you can follow me and get workouts and maybe even some nutritional advice and things like that. Maybe some silly family stuff going on there too. So check it out. You might like it. If you like it, follow me. I hope to see y'all soon.